Hi, this is Susan Elliott, author of Getting Past Your Breakup and Getting Back Out There. I know I haven't made a video in a long time, but because the holidays are upon us and many people are having a bit of an issue with it, I thought that I would share with you a couple of tips to get through the holidays a bit better. One of the topics that I want to talk about is when we are absolutely in disbelief about how somebody else is behaving toward us. Many times we become so obsessed with how someone else is acting that we try to figure out their behavior and we try to understand why are they acting the way that they're acting. We become so focused on someone else that we lose our focus of ourselves. When I was a very young retail manager, I had worked for some corporations that when you came to work for them, they gave you polygraph tests because honesty was so important. I went to work for one corporation and instead of giving a polygraph, they gave a written assessment. And after I was hired, I had to give this written assessment to people that I would hire. So I had to sit down with the people who made up this test and go through each of the questions to find out what each one meant and how I could assess people's honesty with it. To me, it seemed crazy after working for so many companies that use polygraphs. But one question stuck for me. It was, do you think that people are basically honest or dishonest? That question is something that really lets you know about the honesty of another person. Dishonest people tend to think that other people are dishonest. I'm sure that you know people who have lied to you, and yet they're the type of person who accuses everyone else of lying. My ex-husband was like that. He would lie, but he would accuse everybody else of lying. Nobody else was ever telling the truth. And the thing is, because he was a pathological liar. And it's very hard to understand how someone who's a liar could go around accusing everybody else of lying and holding themselves out to be honest. But honest people don't go around doing that. They take people at their word. And that's one of the problems that we have when we're trying to let go of somebody who has not treated us well. We believe that people will treat people the way we treat people. I was recently dealing with a lot of serious health issues. And there were some people who knew that I was, and I didn't hear from them. So when we finally talked, I said, I haven't heard from you. And the person said, you know, communication is a two-way street. I was in the hospital. Is visiting a two-way street? I mean, was I supposed to get out of my hospital bed and drive to your house and have coffee? I mean, what does that mean? When somebody is ill or dealing with health issues or having a hard time, I reach out to them. I believe that's what you're supposed to do. I send flowers. I send gift baskets. I do things like that. And when I'm having a hard time and I'm going through health things and I don't get the gift baskets or the phone calls or the reaching out, I can't believe it. You know, it takes me a while to understand this is who this person is. That it usually takes some monumental episode for you to really find out what a person's made of and who they are and what their real value to is your life. I used to hang out with a group of friends, and after my mother died, there was only one or two that I got a card from. There was only one or two that showed up at the funeral. I thought that these other people were my friends. And sure, there's some people that don't know how to handle when someone dies, but you can send a card. I think that one of our problems is that when we're good people and we treat people right and we think that people care and people appreciate it, we think that when we need it, it will be coming back. We think that when someone tells us they care about us, they do care about us. We can't understand that they don't. Or we can't understand that they could say, I'm over my ex. And then the next thing you know, they're back with them. We can't understand how somebody can treat you so well one minute and walk out the door the next minute. And our first thought is, I would never do that. And that's the problem. We don't understand that other people do that. We can flip through the newspaper and see that somebody's murdered 12 people. And we think, what kind of person murders 12 people? Like, who is that? But because we're not a person who got murdered, we don't know any of the people that got murdered, and we don't know the murderer, we tend to flip through again. But if it's somebody that we care about, we will say, how could they do that? And that's the problem. We see the world the way we are. We need to understand and to accept that other people can be real jerks a lot of times. And we have to come to the decision that we're not going to keep focusing on how could they, why did they, why are they blaming me for their bad behavior. We have to just realize that's who they are, that's who they're going to be, and we have to let them go. We can't beat our head against the wall. We can't keep focusing on them. We have to do our own work. You can do this. The very first step of accepting that this is how they are and this is how it is very, very hard. But it's something you have to do. And I know how hard it is. And believe me, I've had recent experiences with it that I do know how hard it is. You can do this. And you'll feel much more at peace once you do. You can do it.